Good morning, students. My name is P. Navin Jos, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Rohini College of Engineering and Technology. Today, we are going to discuss about the new subject, ME8501, Metrology and Measurements.
In metrology and measurement, the first unit contains basics of metrology. Basics of metrology is nothing but we should know about the fundamentals of the metrology and measurements. In the first unit, we are going to discuss various topics. The first one is introduction to metrology. Introduction to metrology is nothing but what is meant by metrology and what is meant by measurement. Then what are the need of metrology and elements of metrology. Then what is the use of workpiece, instruments, persons, environment in the metrology and measurements. Then what is meant by precision and accuracy. Then what is meant by error. How we are going to find out the error in measurement. What are the types of errors. These are things we are going to study. Then what is meant by control and what is meant by standard and what are the types of standards. These are the entire thing we are going to study in the basics of metrology, and these things how we are going to use in the industry purpose. These are things we are going to study in the basics of metrology. Okay, what is my course outcome? Course outcome is nothing but by the end of this unit, what are the things we learned from this first unit? Here, in first unit, we are discussed about the standards of measurements, limits, fits and tolerances in the usage of industrial application. Introduction to metrology. Okay, what is meant by metrology? We should know about what is meant by metrology. Metrology is nothing but the two words metro and logy, the two Greek words which is combined, and it is derived as metrology. The metro and logy which is combined and derived as metrology. So what is meant by metro? Metro is nothing but measurement. Metro means measurement and logy means science. So the combined metrology is named as science of pure measurement. Metrology is nothing but science of pure measurement. It is named as science of pure measurement. This metrology is depends mainly on the measurement to find out the length, height or breadth of any particular element. Okay, then what are the other things need for metrology? Metrology demands pure knowledge of basic mathematical calculations and physical principles. Metrology needs the basic things of basic fundamentals of mathematical calculations and its physical principles. The physical principles of the particular element. Nowadays in industries, development largely depends on the engineering metrology. Engineering metrology is the basic thing of the particular industry for the development of the of that particular industry. Okay, the next topic is objectives of metrology. Okay, what is meant by objective? Objective is nothing but aim or goal. What is meant by aim? We should aim something about any particular project or object in future, what it can be. We should think about that before itself, in future, what we are going to come, that is called as objective. Any particular project or object, what is, we should aim, what is the scope of this particular project in future, that is called as objective. Although here the basic objective of the measurement is to provide required accuracy at a minimum cost. The main objective of the metrology is nothing but the measurement is to provide required accuracy of a particular object at a minimum cost. And then nowadays in modern engineering plant, the objectives should vary according to the need of metrology. But the main objective is nothing but we should achieve the required accuracy at a minimum cost of the production. Okay, then the different objectives are as follows. The first one is complete evaluation of newly developed products. We should evaluate the newly developed product completely for the required achievement, or we should evaluate whether it is achieved the given dimensions or in the newly developed product. Then the second one is determination of the process capabilities and ensure that these are better than the relevant component tolerances. We should determine the process capabilities and make sure that these process capabilities are better than the relevant component tolerances. Relevant component tolerances, these process capabilities are better than that. We should make sure that about that. Then we should determine the third one is we should determine the measuring instrument capabilities, the instrument capabilities, and make sure these instruments are sufficient for their respective measurements. These instruments are used to check for the particular product's measurements. Then minimizing the cost of inspection by effective and efficient use of available facilities. By using the available facilities effectively and efficiently, we can minimize the cost of inspection. Then by using the application of statistical quality control techniques, we can reduce the rejects and rework, rejection of a particular product or rework of a particular product. We can reduce by using the application of statistical quality control technique. Then the main objective of the metrology is to standardize the measuring methods. The main objective of the metrology is to standardize the measuring methods and to maintain the accuracy of a product or maintain the measurement by the given dimension. For the given dimension, the product should be maintain the accuracy of the measurement. Then to prepare designs for all gauges and special inspection fixes. We should, the objective of the metrology, the main objective of the metrology is to prepare designs for all gauges and special inspection fixtures. Then we next move on to the next topic, need of metrology. Need of metrology. The main tool for the scientific research is nothing but metrology. The importance of the metrology is nothing. The metrology is used as a tool for the scientific research. Okay, next move on to the second point. This is essential for solving almost all technical problems in the field of engineering. In the field of engineering, metrology is almost solving all the technical problems in engineering and also in production engineering and experimental design. This metrology is need in three different varieties, mainly in the field of almost all engineering problems. Then it is mainly in the production field and also in the designing field. Okay, for example, a design engineer should not check his design only from the point of view of strength or economical production. He should always keep in his mind how the dimensions specified can be checked or measured. He should always keep in his mind how the dimensions specified can be checked or measured. Then the third one is higher productivity and accuracy is called for the present manufacturing techniques. In the present manufacturing techniques, the higher productivity and accuracy is most important. This cannot be achieved unless the science of metrology is understood. We should understood the science of metrology, which means the how we are going to measure the product or object, then only we can get the higher productivity and accuracy in the manufacturing field. Okay, the next one is importance of metrology to achieve the quality in quality control in production. Okay, how we are going to achieve the quality control in production? What is going to be quality control? Quality control is nothing but the system or the process which is maintaining the given dimensions. When we are going to manufacture some product, the standards of process and the dimensions are given which we are going to manufacturing some product according to the given dimensions. So the production must be manufacture of the product must be maintained according to the given dimensions. That is called as quality control. So we should maintain the given dimensions for the production, which is called as quality control. So we can achieve the quality control in production. Okay, next one is to achieve the up-to-date production knowledge of the measurement required. To achieve up-to-date production knowledge of the measurement required. Okay, how to achieve the up-to-date production knowledge of the measurement? The production knowledge of the measurement must be changed or vary according to the need of the job or production process. So we should up to date, or in we should know the proper we should get the proper communication or proper knowledge of about the material or production job to maintain or achieve. We can get the measurement of the required product. To reduce rejection rate with the help of quality control. Okay, if we achieve the quality control in production, we can reduce the rejection rate of the particular product in the process. Then, to minimize the cost of production, by using the metrology effectively, we can reduce or minimize the production cost. Then, when we use the metrology properly, we can develop the inspection procedure of for the particular product or in the industrial field applications. We can calibrate the measuring instrument time to time. When we check any object or product, we can check the product with the help of any instrument, but we should calibrate the instrument time to time before checking any object. If it is not in calibrate, it may produce some errors while we inspect any
process. So by this, the session is over. In the next session, we are going to see the next topics in the first unit. Thank you.